story tonight, jury selection in the murder trial of University of Virginia lacrosse player George Huguely continues today in Charlottesville.
Yeah, Huguely pleaded not guilty to the crime yesterday. 11 News reporter Lowell Melcher has been counting it down on Twitter today as the court tries to build a jury.
Well, it is now day two of this trial, and we are still in jury selection, but we are certainly closer than farther with only a couple of potential jurors to go. The hopes are that opening statements will be sometime tomorrow morning, although the judge could extend court hours as he did last night, and we could see those opening statements later this evening. A half-hour early start this morning in the George Huguely murder trial as the Commonwealth and the defense gather with jurors at 9 a.m. This after a long night Monday that ended at 8 p.m. instead of the thought 5 p.m. Huguely, who has lost a noticeable amount of weight since being arrested, sat by his lawyers once again in a suit, his legs weighed down by heavy weights on his ankles as questioning started. Only eight more jurors were needed for the pool of 27, where each side would then cut six for a jury of 12 with three alternates. A little less than 40 jurors were polled in the morning session, and by lunchtime, 22 of 27 jurors were in place. Questions were exactly the same as Monday, as both sides are trying to find jurors who can completely block anything about the case that they know from their minds and come up with an honest verdict. Some highlights included one potential juror who emphatically told the court she thought Huguely was guilty. Another was moved to tears because she said that she had a daughter Yardley Love's age who played sports. Both were dismissed. Some who made the cut, a woman who only listens to public radio and doesn't own a TV, a kindergarten teacher, and a foster care social worker. 11 News has learned, in addition to Yardley Love's mother and sister testifying, George Hughley's father and mother, as well as aunt and uncle, have been added to the witness list. That doesn't necessarily mean they'll testify, but they can. In Charlottesville, Virginia, I'm Lowell Melcer, WBAL-TV 11 News.